Hello, everybody. So it's a next podcast about project management for architecture. So this time we will talk about how to do a good design meeting. So design meeting is something that we do, I don't know, every week or every 2 weeks. You probably know this better than me. But more often than not, the scheduling is not perfect. Some people are not aware really of what are going to be talked about. Often we have too much thing to work on, and at the end half are done. So we are going to tell you about another approach inspired by Agile method that allow to have more performant meeting planning, and at the end to have all the team involved in the development of the project. So I give you the speak, François, to explain about that. And if you have any question, don't hesitate to comment, and we will answer to this question. Thank you.
Hello, Sébastien. Thanks to give
Hello.
me the speak. Hello, everybody. So sorry for a little delay. So we are happy to be with you tonight to present this this new approach. So as Sébastien just said, we are inspired a lot from the IT industry that develop a lot of different methodology. And as you know, in the construction industry, we are not so good in organization. Then there is a lot of lag in this particular aspect. And we are more focusing in the design stage. But it's the same in other stage of the project. Yes, tonight. So actually, we are adjusting a page of the agilebeam.org website. So it's part of a community website where we are sharing all our discussion about how to implement agile methodology in the construction industry, and more specifically with a BIM approach. So you will find a lot of different information and all the meetups that we are organizing. So tonight we are more focusing on how to make a meeting more efficiently with the agile approach. So we are showing you this approach using our tool Bricks. But there is a lot of different tools that you can use. But Bricks is more specific that you can find inside agile tools and specific tools for construction industry. So I will share my screen, Sebastian. Okay. So this is the start page. So actually, we are in a beta stage for us. And so you can create an account. You have a free user, free. So you can create an account directly just now if you want, and test the product. So if you have feedbacks, you are very welcome. Okay, so I will just log in. So this is my list of projects. So I will connect to the specific project for this webinar. So I have different tab, and to organize my meetings, I will go to the roadmap tab. So here I can create the stage of the project. So actually we create two stage, so the concept design stage and the technical design stage. So if I want to configure this stage, I can add a name, a statue. So actually it's in preparation, so I will go to started. I can add a description and a start date and a end date. Okay. So I have the first meeting and the technical design stage, sorry. So I can go to this view. So, okay. So the concept design stage, it's in April and May, and the technical design stage, it's in June and July. So I will zoom a little bit. So after in the agile approach, is based on iteration. So when you have a stage like this for 2 months, you have to cut this part of time in a more little part of time, and the name of this part of time is sprint. So you have to create sprints that are always the same duration. So normally it's 1 to 3 weeks, and you have to cut all your stage with this sprint. So we create a first meeting here. So I will create all my meeting for this stage. So here it's meeting now. So what is a meeting? In fact, in Agile, you have iteration. So all the project is like this, but we know that in a construction industry, it's not totally the same. But if you think about how you share your BIM model, for example, normally you decide with the BIM manager to share your model every 1 week or every 2 weeks. So you have this kind of iteration. So you can choose to create this sprint the same way you share your BIM model, for example, or probably you have a design meeting every week. So you can create a sprint every week and use it for the design meeting. So you can choose how to use this sprint. So I want to create a new sprint. So it's meeting 2. So it will be in preparation, and the date it's so it's 2 weeks.
The idea of Agile Sprint is to help you prioritize topics, tasks to be done. So that you know in advance that you are able to do them, because often people want, okay, for the next meeting I want that, but you perfectly know that it's not possible to do them, even if you work at night and so on. So you need at the end the time is limited, so you need to decide what is possible to do. And if you have 20 tasks to do and the possibility to do only 10 of them, it's better to decide which 10 will be finished instead of not deciding at all and just delivering what you can. So this is the main concept of using sprint in Scrum and in Agile method. And how you're going to prioritize the task, it's basically with their complexity, but also with their importance for your client or for the project in general. So, for example, if the client asks you to do something that you think are not needed or are secondary, using this approach is a way to negotiate with your client to pin what is really important for him. So now you can continue, François.
Yeah. Yes. So I create all the meeting. So I create 4 meeting. So as you see, you can move the duration of the meeting like this. So graphically, it's very easy. So now I know that in the concept design, I have 3 part of time and 3 meeting at the end. So it's easier to organize my production, because I have a good vision of all the meeting, and after we can more easily hierarchize the things to do. So actually, yes, Sébastien, you talk about hierarchization of the topics. So I will show you here is the most basic view in Bricks. So it's just the list of all the topics we have. So some people create some topics to do, and I will go to the board view. So probably you know this type of view. It's like in other tools like Trello, you can view like this. So it's a Kanban view. You can do the same with some post-it on your wall, but here it's in an app. So I have all this topic, And I will use a specific board, the sprint board, where I can see all the subject I have in my project, and I will try to put them in the different meetings I have on the designs on the design stage. So this one is important. We have to do this at the beginning. So the clash detection is in the meeting 3. Design bathroom, okay, on level 3. Meeting 2. Okay, so if I create at the beginning, if I create a different subject on my project because I know I have to do this or that, I can use this view to move all these subjects. And now I can see directly the production in the different sprints. So after I go back to the roadmap, and if I click on the meeting 1. I have the topic to do in that meeting. So in your project, the idea, yes, it's to when you can create a lot of different subjects from the beginning and move them to different meeting. And after when you start your first meeting, you can open this type of view. And okay, you say okay. We saw that we have all this subject to do, and we can create new topics. So we can create. Okay, we can say okay. We have to create the first BIM model. Okay, sure. I can add some properties. For example, it's for the architect. I can assign to Sebastian for and yes, stage it will be automatically okay. So this is also okay. So and you can create different topic and say okay in this for the next meeting you have to do all this subject. And at the end of the meeting, everybody is agree with that. And for all the subjects, you can open the subject and add more context, more so you can add a description.
It is important to add some information, some context as you are.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Because often people think that creating a task with just a title is enough. But what happened in this case is that you, as a project manager in an architect company, for example, you think that your colleague understand everything, but of course it's not the case. So it is necessary to detail as much as possible the expectation so that it is clear for everybody. So you can describe it in a text with some bullet point or something like this, but you can also add some subtasks as François did. And often a task is not only done by one person. So here we can demonstrate how to split a task to be worked by several persons.
Yes. So someone have to move grid A to B. So to organize the structure. So I had a description. I had a task list and. I share DWG is for me, move grid is for Sebastian, and I can add a comment and tag Sebastian to see if it's okay. So during the sprint, so in between two meetings, we can exchange in that topic, and Sebastian can comment. He can say okay, this is me. I can say when I send the DWG, I can check this task, and we organize like that. Okay, so
one aspect we have not talked about is the estimation. So if you can open one topic. So in Bricks and in Agile more generally, there is a system of estimation that is not based on time, as you probably have experience with. So we are not going to say, okay, this is going to take 1 day or 10 hours or 4 hours. Why? Because if you are too precise with estimation, often you are not your estimation is always false. We always know that sometimes it's very hard to estimate. But why we estimate is more to have a broad view, a general view of what is more complicated, what is more simple. So in the Scrum, and we followed this strategy, they use a scale called the Fibonacci scale, which is with some points, some story points. And it's a simple scale. Each step double the previous step. And the idea is, and generally you use the bottom of the scale. For example, a complicated task generally is around 13 or 21. If it is bigger than this point, you need to split it because it's too big. And the idea is to identify when it is too big, when it's not possible to do this task in one sprint. And in this case, it's necessary to split the task, but also to know if a task is very simple, one or two, for example, and that can be done in only one day. So even if it is not very priority, it is better to do it so it is done. Or if a task is really complicated and that's it. And this estimation can really be discussed with the team. It's not the role of the project manager to say, okay, this will be a 3 point, a 5 point. Generally, it's a discussion that the team member are going to have at the beginning of the session, at the beginning of the sprint. So if the sprint is 1 week, at the beginning of the week, and people exchange about their opinions, they could have a different opinion. And at the end, we need to have a good view on the complexity of the task. So you can continue, François.
Yes, so here you can see it's very 16 points in all the meeting. So at the beginning, it means nothing for the team. But when you make a lot of different sprints with the same team, you know that, okay, 16, it's okay. And when it's more than 20, we will have problem to finish the sprint. So idea, it's at the end, when you say at the end of the meeting, you say, okay, we will do all these tasks, everybody, have to do this task, and if we don't finish the task, there is a problem. So the team has to organize to finish the task they are engaged in. And so after, yes, when during the two meetings, you can go to the board view, and here you can see. I put this task in doing because I send the TWG to Sébastien, and Sébastien can open the task. See, okay, it's okay for François. So I will move the grid in my model, and after he can check here and put it in done. So this task, it's okay. And the other task is this one. So you can put it in doing. So as a project manager or the BIM manager, you can go here into this view and check where is the work. Do I have to help some people to finish the work at the end of the sprint? Could be interesting. Also, you can filter the Kanban view by assignment, sorry. So I can see that Sébastien have one task and François no task for the moment. So I can see if some people have too much task and so on. So it could be interesting to have a global view of the work during two meetings. So when the sprint is finished, so you have a new meeting. So you can open this view, and you see, and you go to one topic to another, and with the team, you check if the work is done or not, and what are the problems. So this topic, it's okay. So I can say
Mark has done,
sorry. Mark has urgent note, where it is. No, it's not here. Okay, but this one is okay, but this one it's not okay. So you just create the model, but you don't share, okay. Can I see Mark has done?
No, but edit the topic and change the state.
Okay.
I think maybe your user didn't have the permission, but normally it works. Ah, it's already done. Okay.
Okay. And so you check all the different topics, and you can put a new comment and say okay for that. So as a project manager, for example, you can okay for that subject. So everybody know that okay there is a validation for that subject, and at the end you say okay we will start a new meeting, new iteration, so with a new meeting at the end, and you can because I don't start the sprint, so that's why probably no. So you have to start the sprint at the beginning. Sorry. Okay, so the sprint is starting. So you see there is a different icon here. So this sprint is the current sprint. So at the end of the sprint, so I'll check if I say Mark has done here.
No, but you can just end it.
So I can end the sprint. And I can move unfinished topics to the next sprint. And you say, okay, the next sprint is the meeting 2. And here there is one issue that is done and one issue that is incomplete. So, okay. So I close this one. And when I open the meeting 2, there is some topics that previously we moved to this meeting 2, and the topics that are not finished, they are here. And so with the team, so half of the meeting it's to say okay what you have done in the previous sprint, and the other half part of the meeting is what you have to do for the next sprint, and the same you go to one topic to another, and you put some more detail and more information. The idea is that every member of the team have the same level of information. Every member can add some information, and so when you are assigned to a task, you have all the information to do your task in the better way and finish it with more quality.
There is two questions, so I will try to answer to the question. So the first from Francisco is, have the estimation daily? Are we doing, I understand, are we doing the estimation every day? So no, hopefully we do it at the beginning of the sprint. And that's it. It could be re-evaluated sometimes if the evaluation is really bad. It's possible, but generally the evaluation don't change. So it's done only once in 1 week or in 2 weeks. And why it is called meeting if it is a sprint? So in the app in Bricks we call it sprint, but we named the sprint meeting. So you can name it as you want.
It's generical, yes, but you're right. We can say okay, it could be the B meeting number one, B meeting number two, or conception meeting number one, or structural meeting number two. So yes, you have to check with your workflow how you want to name the meeting. Yes, for more comprehension with all the team member, we decide that yes, in Scrum, in Agile, you use the sprint name, but it's more common in our construction industry to speak about a meeting. But you can use it as you want, and as it's more usable in your project. Okay. So, and so at the end, yes, you can create a report with the, you can, if you filter the list of topic by stage by sprint, for example. So not this one. Okay, you can create a report. So here we have a few topics. But you can create a report in a PDF or in Excel and to share the list of these topics to all the team members, so to be sure that they know what to do. But the idea, yeah, for sure, it's not to use email in parallel, but it's that every team members are in the app, and they receive some notification from the app when you start a meeting, when you end a meeting, when you assign them some specific subject or task. So the global idea, as you experience every day, I think, it's to have less emails and use Bricks platform to manage all the project information and have just one source of truth, and to share the same level of information for all the team members. So I think this is a big a big advantage of agile approach. It's to share the same level of information, to have this iteration, so everybody knows the rhythm of the project, and it's more motivation for every team members to have some very clear objective, to share this objective with everybody, and to have more transparency in the way we share information. That we think that is the best advantage of this agile approach in our more traditional industry.
There is two questions. One of Magdalena. So is there a way to collect data about the time consumption of the particular task? So no, in Bricks we don't have currently a way to combine. We have only the estimation with Spawn, but we don't yet have a way to define, enfin, to save the fact that we have at the end consume, I don't know, 8 hours, 12 hours. Maybe it will be an evolution, but we will see. After, can you automatically set the sprint length to 2 weeks from Tatiana? Or yes. Do you have to choose the date on the calendar? So currently, no, not yet. We don't have a way to set to 2 weeks. It's a good idea. Thank you.
Yeah, it's a good idea. So we're in beta stage. So it's thanks to add this idea. And we think also to when you create a stage to automatically cut the stage in sprint. So you can say, okay, my sprint is 1 or 2 or 3 weeks, and Bricks will cut the stage in the number of sprint. So thanks. Yes, for this idea, we will check it.
And good suggestion also from Trevor. Yeah, if you want to be serious about time tracking, Toggle app is really great and very simple. So it's not always good to have one tool for everything, and Toggle is doing the job really good. So I think it's possible to combine. It's a good idea. And after, do we have a burnout chart? Not yet. Of course, it's needed. In Agile, it's a must to have. So for those who don't know, it's a chart that describes the status of completion, and that is used during the sprint to know, for example, if you at the end, the sprint are going to end, and in 2 days, you see that nothing is done. So your chart will be really flat. And also after if it is in a good state, it's graphical. I should see something to be more explicit, but it is a line that go down evenly. And at the end of the sprint, it's good also to see if the sprint was successful or not. So it's something that we want to add at the end of the sprint to have this chart, of course. And probably also an automatical sending of a report. So we think about this addition. So
keep in mind. We are also experiencing our tool with some teams in construction, and the first step is to decide people to work with sprints. And so burn down chart. As Sébastien said. Probably now with the use of the sprint, there is no, and people don't put every day the information. So probably will not be so much interesting. But yes, we are working on some graphical report. So we will tell you very soon, I think, some more information about that.
You're right, François, the challenge by adopting this methodology. By the way, you can use to start this methodology, you are not obliged to use a web app, and you can really start with a post-it on the wall, and that's great also. But the challenge is to put all your team members together, and that all your team members believe in this approach. So if the board, the Kanban board we displayed, is not updated, it is less useful, of course. So the challenge is that, and it's more challenge of human human psychology than a tool. So we, by the way, with Agile Beam community we talk about at the beginning, we are doing some meetups and some speaker so that we experience the Agile method on a real project, talk about their experience. So I think it's by listening to their advice that we can improve our agility.
Yes. Okay, so I don't know if we have some more questions. We can share the BRICS website if you want. And so thank you very much, everybody, to watch our webinar and for your question. We hope that you have a more global view of how to organize your meeting with this agile approach. So we encourage you to create a free account in BRICS and to use it in this way. So we can see again the webinar in YouTube in a few hours or a few days, I think. And after when you create an account, you can take a specific meeting with us. So it's a 30 minutes or to 1 hour meeting to talk more about your specific problem and how could agility could help you in your construction project. So don't hesitate to take this specific meeting with us, and we will be very happy to talk with you and to talk about your way of working and to be more agile in the construction industry. And if you have other idea to add in the app, it could be very helpful also. So thank you, everybody. Thank you, Sébastien.
Great job.
See you soon. We will see you soon in French next webinar, and for other subjects in English, I think.
Okay. Bye-bye. Thank you. Bye-bye. Thank you all.